evening. We'd like to call Plaquemines Parish School Board meeting to order at Belchess Elementary School Multipurpose Building, Monday, July 12, 2021, at 6:04 p.m. We'll have invocation by Ms. Monica Wirtz and Pledge of Allegiance by Nico Tesevich.
If you would please bow your heads. Almighty God, we give you our schools. We give you our teachers, our staff, and all who work here. We give you our children who study here. We pray for our school system to be a great place of discovery, adventure, and creativity. May it be a place where we all love to learn and where we learn to love. A place where everyone is respected and all are deeply valued. We ask this through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.
Roll call and declaration of quorum, Ms. Monica.
Darylyn Turner DeMaul.
Here.
Daniel Morrell.
Here.
Nico Tesevich.
Present.
Joyce Lampkin. Wayne Myers.
Here.
Fran Bailly Martinez.
Here.
Bobby Ingraham. Paul LeMaire.
Here.
Jennifer Sanger.
Here.
Madam Chairman, President, you have a quorum.
Thank you. 1.04, approval of agenda. Call for a motion.
I make a motion.
You have to read the agenda.
You gotta read.
I'll second it.
The motion is with the...
There's one addendum.
Yes, the motion is with the addendum. Yes. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion carries. 1.05 ad hoc and standing committee reports. We have two.
Madam President?
Services. You want to read it?
You want me to start?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, we had a student service committee meeting on Thursday, June 14th at the Plaquemines Learning Center. The meeting was called at 4:40 p.m. Members present were Paul LeMaire, Joyce Lampkin, Darylyn DeMaul Turney, Nico Tesevich. Others present was Fran Bahi Martinez, Dennis Roussel, Monica Wirtz, Catherine Phelan, Donna Norris, John Vanison, and Sonia DePlessis. The committee chairman, Paul LeMaire, invited several high school students to the meeting in an effort to obtain feedback and recommendations pertaining to the school lunch menus with the district, particularly at the high school level. The following students participated in the discussion: Tia Bartholomew, South Plaque High School; Levingston Cohen, South Plaque High School; Trace Williams, Belchase High School; Larry O'Turner, Phoenix High School; Jaslyn Martin, Phoenix High School; Cameron Williams, South Plaquemines High School; and Brooke Ingraham, South Plaque High School. The first item on the agenda was discussion of the school lunch menu for the 2021-2022 school year. Donna Norris, Food Service Supervisor, provided an update on lunch menus for the past year. For the 2020-2021 school year, our schools were under the summer food service guidelines. Breakfast was grab and go. Lunch was sent to the classroom, only offering one entry for breakfast and one entry for lunch, along with fruit, vegetable, grain, and milk requirements. Ms. Norris mentioned she met with food brokers and other food service managers to see new products and tested new recipes at some of the schools to revamp our menus. The students and Ms. Norris went through four-week cycle menus for breakfast, lunch, and adjusted entries on both meals. Students wanted more than one choice for breakfast and lunch, spicy chicken sandwiches more often, and when entry was, did not care for as much was on the menu, add entry they liked or preferred. Ms. Norris ensured students were back to full menu with three choices for breakfast, more than one choice for lunch, and a variety of vegetable, grain, and fruit choices. The students were thanked for their input and time given to participate. The next item discussed of the review was proposed revision to adoption of school board policies, student conduct, and political activities, proposed adoption. The committee agreed on the revisions and adoption, however, requested that the policies are sent to school board lawyer before presenting to the full board for approval. There being no further business, the meeting was adjourned at 5:50 p.m.
Finance. The Finance and Budget Committee met June 17, 2021. The meeting was called to order at 5:25. Members present were Joyce Lampkin, Chair, Paul Lemaire, Fran Bae Martinez, Darylyn DeMaul Turner, Dennis Roussel, Catherine Phelan. Others present were Nico Tesvich, Monica Wirtz, Shelley Ritz, John Vanison, and Sonia DePlessis. The first item on the agenda was a discussion of the proposed budget adoption schedule for 2021 to 2022 year. Ms. Phelan presented the required schedule for recommendations to the full board for approval. The next item on the agenda was a discussion of the property tax millages renewal to be levied for 2021. There were several questions regarding the renewal and what course of action was required at this time. Ms. Phelan informed the committee of an upcoming meeting scheduled with the assessor's office and would gather additional details regarding the next course of action regarding the matter. The final item on the agenda was noted as information only by the Superintendent Roussel regarding the 2021 state pay raises to teachers and support staff effective July 1st. There being no further business, the meeting was adjourned at 5:45 p.m.
Number two, Plaquemines Parish School Board recognitions and our presentation. I don't think we have any. Board members, time for non-agenda and agenda items. We already did that, huh? 3.01, discussion and appropriate action in regards to approval of revised school board policy, JCDA Student Code of Conduct, a waiver of second reading, Darylyn DeMaul Turner, Joyce Lampkin. This is about the student code of conduct that we went over at the meeting. Call for a motion.
I'll make a motion.
I'll second.
Oh, second by Ms. Martinez. And it's kind of just trying to adopt the policy. So, anybody have any questions about it?
I was wondering about, since we have two files in board docs in the board packet, which one is it that we're approving of the two that's under administrative content? We're voting to approve JCDA 21?
JCDA.
Okay, and it's the first one listed, the one that's 29 kilobytes?
Mr. Tesvich, why don't you look at the policy that you, it may be 9 pages. You will also see the inserts or the edits in the blue that came from the policy management company, and that's the policy that we're looking to adopt.
It's under rule number one.
So the only, correct me if I'm wrong, the only change that we're making to that policy, JCDA, is the one with, is the text in blue. That is the only change.
Yes, sir, that's the only thing that was added.
We're adding it.
Everything else was part of the existing policy. When we had the big committee of the board meeting, uh-huh. that was the page 3 out of 8.
Yep.
There was some formatting done by the policy management company. Now it's 9 pages, but we can tweak that.
Okay.
Well, we can't. The policy company will be able to do that.
All right. Thank you for that clarification.
You're welcome.
Any other questions from the board? Questions from the audience? All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion carries. 3.02, discussion and appropriate action regard to adopting new school board policies, GAHB, political activities, with waiver of second reading, Darrell and DeMar Turner, board president. This was a big discussion for us. Can we call for a motion? I mean, I'm sorry, yes, call for a motion. Motion by Ms. Fran, second by Mr. Lemire. Y'all need a minute to go over that one?
I think that part was discussed with the attorney, and he reworded it the way he felt like it should be reworded.
And again, on same kind of question as last time, because I see we have one that's final and one that's new. So it's the final one that's in the board packet is the one we're voting on?
Yes, sir. It's all black.
Okay. Any other questions?
I have a question.
Sure.
Will this prevent the senior prank situation that we had, which was why we were openly discussing this? Will this change stop that from happening?
Well, rules never stop people from breaking them.
And just the senior plank is not something that the school board adopted. That's just something that is schools just do. They give seniors the opportunity to do it. It's not something that we adopted or there's a policy for it. That's just, you know, a voluntary thing that kids do at the school. So that's, you know, on the principal to say that you can't do it.
So the enforcement of this policy will be done by the principals at any extracurricular activity, not necessarily extracurricular, any activity on school grounds, it's gonna fall on the principal and or administration of that school to enforce this policy, correct?
Remember, you were that?
I know, I'm just clarifying.
If it's a policy that needs to be, if it's something that needs to be approved, it has to go to the principal and the superintendent.
Yeah.
So, yeah, and most things, Mr. Russo, I kind of.
Wait, not the activity. I'm not saying the activity. I'm saying so as the policy's written, it says that therefore the school board shall prohibit all political activities with the exception of certain educational activities, which we talked about in the meeting. This prohibition shall include the wearing of clothing, buttons, et cetera, advertising political candidates, parties, political proposition. By employees and students. So it doesn't exclude anyone who is not an employee or student to do something politically I'm messing up my words here. Someone who is not an employee or a student that is on school property doing something politically motivated, I'll say, it doesn't prevent them from doing that. So someone can show up with, if someone is, Joe Johnson is running for parish president in the next parish president election. If Joe Johnson, who is not a student or employee, shows up to a football game at South Plaquemines High School, that is an acceptable activity. That is an allowed thing. Like, we can't tell him, you gotta take off your Joe Johnson for parish president shirt. And I hope I'm trying to make this clear, because I had a lot of questions from my constituents about the policy, and I just want to make sure we're clear on it before we vote on it.
I'm a little confused.
I'm under the impression if they want to pass out things at a football game or anything, they have to go through the superintendent and the principal.
Right. But, okay. But what I'm confused on is the way that the policy is written, the policy that we're voting on, it says that it prohibits all the activities, and then it also, make sure I'm reading this right, and it also prohibits wearing stuff or advertising for a political candidate by employees and students, but not necessarily someone who is not an employee or student on school property. And I'm just trying to make sure.
When this policy went to the attorney for his review, requested by us, this policy was mainly written for the students and for our employees. In regards to the private citizens, we're limited what we can do with that. We're only voting on this as our school board policy. And as Mr. Hammond said, we have to be very careful with the First Amendment rights, because once we infringe on that, then we have an issue. That's why this policy is so limited and so condensed regarding employees and students. I don't think we can police the citizens coming into the state.
Right.
I agree.
But you can because it's a school activity.
Ma'am.
So when you're talking about a school activity which is on school board property, you have the right to turn people away because it's a school activity. It's not a public activity where you're coming out, from the community and say, I'm going to. It still falls under school board activities.
School board property, yes.
Yeah, it's school board property, which means it's a school board activity. So
I do see some gray area here, especially bringing up a football game, and it's saying employees and students on school property. So on Friday night, if my son, who's a student at South Plaquemines High School, shows up wearing a shirt saying vote for Jennifer Sanger for school board, are we going to tell him he cannot wear that at a football game because he's on school property?
According to this policy, I would say yes.
Yeah, because we discussed that in the committee meeting, and we said that we'd ask him to turn the shirt inside out, or they would have to.
Okay, I wasn't at the committee meeting, so I wanted to make sure that you all agreed on that.
You definitely have to ask questions. So that was one of the things we talked about.
Okay.
So we have to remember that this is school, it's a school board property. So it's a school activity, which means it's not for a public, for communities that I can come and wear what I want. It's still a school activity. So we have to understand that certain things you can and cannot do. So you can't wear a t-shirt that says vote for Nico Tesovich, school board member. So because it's a school activity. So that's the area that people have to understand.
Yeah, I'm with you, Ms. Turner. I'm
LSU,
clarifying for everybody that's watching on YouTube. I'm making sure everybody
understands.
If you
want to go to LSU game and wear, vote for Nico Tesovich, that's fine by me.
So
anything that involves Plaquemines Parish School Board activities, you just can't wear that.
So with that being said, if a visiting team parent shows up with a vote for, we're going to ask them to turn their shirt around also?
If need be, yes.
Well, no, if need be,
it's a school board, it's a school activity.
She needs to be. Darylin, it's not time for her to speak.
We're going to have to, you have opportunity to fill out a card and come up and discuss that if you need be.
I wasn't at the committee meeting. I just see that there's a lot of gray and unanswered still questions on this. And my belief is that it doesn't, I know why we visited this issue, and I don't feel that this fixes or changes that issue. So,
have we considered the policing of this, putting this on our staff? Was that discussed? I really wish I could have been at this committee meeting. I'm sorry, I was out of state. But, we're leaving the staff at the high schools for events outside of the school day. I'm not talking about during a regular school day, but at events that are not during the regular school day, school functions outside of, whether it's graduations, assemblies, athletic games, and stuff like that. Are we being fair to our staff and administration in policing this policy of watching people's clothing and attire for advertising for political parties and things of that nature. I'm just asking if we took that into consideration.
Wait, so you're saying that when they come in, to like when you're paying to get into a football game, I think we should be able to watch who's coming in. But what I mean, that's kind of easy to see what somebody. I mean, if he's meaning unzip your jacket or whatever the case is, it has to happen. But again, if you guys want to go back and revisit this policy and change or add something, we can do that.
My question is, I don't think we are not. I am not. I can't tell the parents. We're not in charge of the parents. We're in charge. This says we're in charge of school board employees and the students. The parents ought to be able to come to the game. They can wear. We can't tell. Can we tell? We're going to tell them what they can wear?
No.
No. So I don't see how. Parents can wear whatever, they can wear a shirt. We're saying we're not in charge of the parents. Our job is for the students, the schools.
Madam President, can we defer this and like you said, revisit it? And I'll make sure that at the next meeting that I'm available, and that way I don't have any reservations about it.
And this is something we need to do before the next school board meeting. So we need to have a committee of the board meet, and then we'd have to have a special school board meet because it needs to be adopted before school starts on August 9th.
I'm okay with that.
Okay. So we're going to defer 3.02 for.
I'll withdraw my second.
Okay.
And then we can defer.
I'll make a second to defer.
So we need a motion to defer.
Well, I'll make a motion to defer.
We definitely need a date, like next week.
I'm gone at that time.
Is everybody available for July 21st?
I'm going to be out of town.
July 22nd?
Yeah, I'll be out until the 24th. I mean, I don't have to be there, but.
You want to shoot for the 26th or the 27th?
I'm not going to be there. I'll have the joint session.
We need to come up with a date. We have, if we defer this next week, we have to come up with a date. So July 21st.
Why are we looking at that week?
What time is the other meeting for?
The finance meeting. What time? 4:00.
Okay. So 5:00 we'll have a student service meeting. 5:00, July 21st, student service committee to board meeting.
I'm good with that.
That's good. 5:00.
5:00, July 21st.
Somebody's going to have to take my place as the chair that day because I won't be here.
Okay. July 21st, 5:00 p.m., Student Services Committee to Board Meeting.
And we have a Finance Committee meeting. We have a Finance Committee meeting at 4:00. That same day.
Right. Where's the meeting?
Where's the Finance Committee meeting?
That's fine.
Okay.
Transportation. So both meetings will be at the transportation office.
So I make a motion to defer?
Till July, yeah.
Till after the meeting of July 21st.
Okay. At 5:00.
At 5:00.
At the transportation building.
At the transportation building, everybody.
We have a second? Thank you. All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Aye. Motion carries. Any board member wants to speak? It is time for board members' agenda, non-agenda items. Thank you for your hospitality. I don't guess nobody else. Ms. Cooper, I'm sorry. That threw me for a loop. It's okay. I'm usually on, you know. All right.
Ms. Turner, I would like to say something also, please. Mm-hmm. I just wanted to recognize that we hired a new basketball coach at South Plaquemines High School, and he's a former student who graduated from South Plaquemines High School, and he played college ball and the developmental league for the NBA. His name is Rodney Bartholomew. So we're very proud to have a local homeboy come coach our team. So look out, Phoenix. We're coming for you.
I'm just about to say, let me pass that on real quick so we can start practicing now. No, congratulations. That's awesome.
Oh, also had a couple athletic achievements to mention. Softball Bell Chase had, I believe, Gracie Hess was nominated to the All-Metro softball team. Congrats to her. And we also had, I believe, the boys 3200 relay team was also noted as All-State at Bell Chase High School. So congratulations to those two sports teams. In addition, I have a very polite and humble request. Any coaches in the parish of any sport, if you want to share your schedule, your football schedule, softball schedule, basketball schedule, what have you, feel free to forward them to me or any parent group that's, you know, heading football dads or moms or whatever. Send it over to me, and I'd like to share them on social media so as many people as possible can understand when our athletic teams are playing this year, and as many people as we can come out and support them. Thanks.
Any other board member? All right. Number four, superintendent's comments and reports. Turn that over to Ms. Monica.
4.01, discussion regarding a request for right-of-way drainage and waterman servitude at Bell Chase Middle School, PPSB property, Mr. Ken Dugas, Plaquemines Parish Government, Engineering and Public Works Department.
I'll offer.
Second.
Good evening, board members, Madam Chairman, administration. I'm here really to answer questions for our project. As you may be well aware of, there's a sewer project that is going down that extends down to Bartholomew Lane, which is just north of the Bell Chase Middle School. The parish was awarded $7 million for the sewer extension on a CDBG, Community Development Block Grant Program. And we found out under construction that we have a constructability issue with the sewer line going down Bartholomew Lane, that we would like to install a new water main on the school board property outside the fence. So we're here, I sent everyone an email, or I sent Ms. Sonia an email to pass on to the board members. If you had a chance to look at it, I have hard copies here of partial of the plans that Linfield Hunter and Junior has prepared, as well as a Google Earth map that kind of illustrates the location of the water main, and then the actual survey that the parish is getting completed for the dedication of the servitude. At this point, the property dimensions are around 22 feet from the outside the fence to your property line. That we need 20 feet would be sufficient if we want to do a 20-foot dedication. And basically, I'm here to answer any questions. Within this program, there is no cost to PPSB, PPG, it's all CDBG funded. So you can rest assured taxpayers' money is coming from the state on this one. So we're okay. And then if you have any questions.
I know I spoke to you before the meeting. I just have one question. There at the street, or I guess at the road where it starts,
yes.
Are they going to have like a lift? They're not a lift station going to be there or anything, is there?
The lift station is actually down Bartholomew Lane.
At the back, on the back side?
About midway through.
Midway through. So I guess my question is, are they going to put any type of greenery around that or a fencing? I know some of them have fencing.
Typically there's fencing around lift stations. It could be chain link. It could be wooden fence. It all depends. But on your property, there will be no lift stations. The water main is subsurface. Also, added advantage to having a servitude is the parish can go and maintain the ditch all the way to the drainage canal by having a dedicated servitude.
Thank you.
I do
Any
have some extra
questions?
Copies here if you didn't get a chance to look at the electronic files.
Any other questions from the board? We call for a vote.
I make a motion.
We did. We made the motion.
I'll second.
We
oh, we did that right.
It was already. I'm sorry. We have any questions from the audience? Okay. Then we call for a vote. All in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Aye. Any opposed? Motion carries. Thank you.
Thank you all very much.
Thank you. 4.02, discussion and appropriate action in regard to approval of the budget adoption schedule for the 2021-2022 year. Ms. Catherine Phelan, Chief Financial Officer.
Call for a motion.
So offered.
Second.
Good evening. Just to review the budget adoption schedule for the fiscal year 2021-2022. The schedule consists of August 16th, discussion of the proposed 2021-2022 budget. Also, presentation of the proposed 2022 budget. August 17th, proposed 2021-2022 budget is made available for public inspection. Also, on August 17th, there will be a publication of the public notice in the Plaquemines Gazette for the proposed 2021-2022 budget available for inspection for a public hearing to be held on September 13th. On September 13th, we will hold the public hearing for the 21-22 budget and also adopt the 21-22 budget on September 13th.
Any questions from the board? Questions from the audience? Call for a vote. All in favor?
Aye. Aye.
Any
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carries.
4.03, presentation in regard to adopting the property tax millages to be levied for the 2021 year. Ms. Catherine Phelan, Chief Financial Officer.
Good evening again. We have two options for our millages. One is to simply renew the millages, and the second option will be to maximize those millages. We will present you all with an in-depth presentation at the Finance Committee meeting so that you all can make the most informed decision.
Thank you.
Four, discussion and appropriate action in regard to the approval of the district's 2021 hurricane preparation, response and recovery hurricane plan. Mr. Ronald Bateman, Director of Student Services, and Dr. Shelley Ritz will present that information to you.
Call for a motion.
Second.
Mr. Morrell.
Hi, how you doing? Good evening. Mr. Bateman's on vacation this week, but he asked me to let you know if you have any questions or concerns. He went through the process of notifying all directors, department heads, and school principals, reviewed the plan, and he felt secure in the decisions by all departments. Pretty much everything's the same as it was last year. So do you have any questions or anything? He'll be glad to answer them.
Are they going to give us a new pass, or are we still using the same one?
I will definitely check. In the past, it seems like we're getting new stickers.
Stickers.
Yes, ma'am. So I will definitely make note of that and let him know next Monday when he returns.
Can you let him know I never got mine?
I'll make sure he knows that.
Can we make a note that I know last year for several different incidents, not only the hurricanes, but power outages and stuff like that, can we get that addressed where it's out to the public either sooner or readily available to them, whether it be via social media or however? I believe that we might have a Twitter account, or I don't know if we do, but just some other type, because I know everybody on this board for hurricanes, power outages, whatever it may be, we do get a lot of phone calls.
Sure.
And the biggest complaint that I see is that they don't know and they try calling the school, but if the power's out at the school,
correct,
they can't answer the phone. So if we can figure out some platform to get that out, whether it be via text message or something. I think that would help us out a lot.
I will definitely get the information to Mr. Bateman for sure, as well as Mr. Roussel.
Thank you.
No problem.
Any other questions from the board? Questions from the audience? Call for a vote. All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion carries.
Thank you very much.
4.05, Head Start Monthly Budget Report. Ms. Patricia Haydell, Director of Head Start.
Good evening, everybody. Is there any questions? We haven't spent much lately. We're just getting started on our new budget year, but if you have any questions.
How about numbers looking? The numbers, the enrollment.
That's exactly where I was going. So we, as of Thursday afternoon, we have sent out all of our enrollment acceptance and waitlist letters. We're going to be braiding some funds using some of the ESSER funds to give some opportunities to our families who don't necessarily show eligibility because all of our programs are income-based. So we were able to utilize that this year. So that was very helpful. We still are under-enrolled in Head Start. We're looking for eligible families according to the income that's posted on our website. So if any families out there are, you know, are very low-income families, we need them to go ahead and register. We had a bunch of incomplete applications, and as soon as we sent the emails out showing who was accepted, of course, we have a barrage of information coming in. So this week we're working on looking at that information, judging those children to see if they're eligible or over income and seeing where we can adjust to meet the needs of those children too. So we are looking for more kids, but after we get finished with the incomplete applications this week, we may be okay.
Thank you.
All right, thank you.
Five, approval of board consent agenda.
5.01, 5.02, if you would take those together.
Yes.
Need a motion?
So offered.
Second.
Any questions from the board and questions from the audience? Call for a vote. All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion carries. Any information item? Anybody on the board have any information item? Any citizen comments? You gotta come to the mic. And we'll excuse the fact that you didn't, this is your first meeting.
Good afternoon, hi, my name's Christian Asaf. I wanted to apologize, this is my first meeting, but with that item with wearing political stuff, how y'all were saying it said staff and students, just knowing how people are, they will fight you on it because it doesn't, if y'all want to expand it and it include, since it, what you were saying, Ms. Turner, since it is a school property, if y'all want y'all own rule, you know, so there's no arguments or any fighting or with parents and stuff. It just needs to be extended to all people who are coming to the games or whatever, not to have any political shirts or anything. Otherwise, when she was reading the statement that says staff and students, you know you're going to have people that say, it doesn't say family members or parents or stuff like that. That's all. I'm sorry.
No, thank you. No, it's no. We welcome comments from.
Yeah, and I was making.
No, you're fine. You're fine. But we make policies, you know, based on our students, our schools. We really don't make policies for a community. So, but being that we need to revise that policy, we definitely take in comments and concerns.
Yeah, I believe like it's on your grounds
yes.
that y'all could make that.
Yeah,
because I was making an example, like my Uncle Joe coming from New York, say, and he has some political thing on there, and he comes to the ball game to watch his nephew or whatever. You know, and I'm not the one that would be saying, hey, this, but, you know, they may be people out there, this only says this, and so why not? And then you'll have yourself in, you know, that's all.
No, thank you. No, we appreciate it all. Thank you. But we definitely will have a committee to the board meeting, and you're welcome to attend July 21st at 5 o'clock at the transportation building, which is literally right down the street from where we are on the right-hand side. Thank you. Date and time and location of the next meeting, Monday, August 16th. Well, we're going to have a special board meeting. But anyway, on according to agenda, the next meeting will be August 16th, 2021 at South Black Elementary School in Port Salvador. We'll call for a motion to adjourn. Nobody wants that? Oh, I'm about to say, y'all don't want to leave. We can stay a little bit longer. Chalmette, don't close till 9 o'clock. All right. All in favor?
Aye.
Motion carries. See y'all next week. Well, I'm sorry. See y'all.